And we welcome you to our postseason preview show here on Yes. Bob Lorenz and Jack Curry with you in studio as the Yankees head into the postseason now, knowing that they will face the Cleveland Indians beginning Tuesday night, what will be a marquee matchup between Gerrit Cole and Shane Bieber.
Right, and when the Yankees signed Gerrit Cole to that contract, more than $300 million, Bob, this was the scenario that they were looking ahead toward. You want Gerrit Cole pitching in game one of a postseason series. Now, the Indians are countering with Shane Bieber, who is going to win the AL Cy Young Award and who statistically had a better season than Cole did. But the Yankees are very confident in Cole, Bob, especially what he did across his last four starts while matched with Kyle Higashioka. And you and I interviewed Cole at his introductory press conference. It's a 9-year contract. We said something about winning a championship as a Yankee, and he said, well, how about multiple championships? How about three? So he's now in position to get the Yankees started on that road. This 60-game season didn't go exactly as the Yankees hoped it would. They were a very streaky team. There were times they were the best team in Major League Baseball, and then times where they struggled, including at the end of the season. They're 0-0 now. They got Cole on the mound. That's reason to be confident.
Could Cole and Bieber go complete games? Possibly. They have the talent to do it. But if not, then you would think bullpen-wise, the Yankees would be favored.
I do think the Yankees have the edge in the bullpen. Brad Hand is the closer for the Cleveland Indians, and he does a really nice job. But I think in terms of depth and versatility, the Yankee bullpen has the edge in this series. But you're right. This will be a mano match in game one. It's a marquee matchup. It's must-see TV. And if you're the Yankees, if you can go to Cleveland, win that first game behind Cole, you've sent this message to the Indians. We just took down your unbeatable force, this guy who had an ERA of under 2 this year, this guy who nobody could beat. So Yankee offense, if you get opportunities against somebody like Bieber, you have to make sure when you get them that you cash in.
All right, let's bring in John Flaherty now. And Flash, the Yankees probably didn't finish the regular season quite the way they wanted to. Having said that, take us in the mind of the players in that clubhouse. Is it pretty easy to sort of hit the reset button with all the juice of the playoffs coming up?
It is, Bob. And, you know, now that you know what the matchup is, and Jack just detailed all of it, that what you're going to have to deal with Bieber, now you try to get your mind right that everything that happened during your 60 games and the way you finished up at 33-27, you know, that's all in, it's all in the past. It's all history. And the good news about facing a guy like Shane Bieber, and there's not a whole lot of good news about it, is that you're just going to have to dig into that batter's box and try to grind and find a way. He's only given up 7 home runs and 12 starts this year. We know the Yankees love to hit the long ball, and that's a recipe for success. You don't know how many opportunities they're going to have to do that. So as a lineup, 1-9, you just got to dig in that box and grind it out. And on any other day, you would feel like the Yankees would have the advantage in the rotation out on the mound. Cole Bieber, to me, I mean, that's a toss-up right there. So it's going to be a classic battle. I think whoever takes game one, obviously in a short series, is going to have the advantage, but will probably take this series because there's a lot of question marks with not the talent of the Cleveland rotation, but some of the youth with Plesac probably in the number 2 spot. So if you take down Bieber in game one, if you're the Yankees, you feel really good moving forward.
Flash, you look at some of the Yankees'